This morning, we're talking health with Dr. Scott Ackerman. There's a promising new experimental, cancer treatment that's using basically a Trojan horse to prompt cancer cells to actually self-destruct. And the best thing here is the patient doesn't have to take any drugs. Joining us this morning is local oncologist Dr. Scott Ackerman. Good morning. Thanks for being with us.
Good morning, Jen.
So this is a sneak attack. It's fascinating. How does it work?
Yeah, it's really cool. This is a study done in the Far East. And what they did was they took these nanoparticles and they coated the nanoparticles with an amino acid. And the amino acid they used is one that's not naturally found in the body. And these nanoparticles would then go into cancer cells. They were doing it on mice. They were injecting them and they were going to cancer cells. And the amino acid that was attached to the nanoparticles, coated on the nanoparticles, would be in the cancer cell. And since this is an amino acid that's not normally found in the body, the cancer cells wouldn't be able to process it properly and they would just explode basically and they would just die. And so it's kind of cool that it's this so-called Trojan horse. You put this normally inert amino acid, it goes into the cell, and then it just causes the cell to die off and explode.
So since this kind of amino acid's not found in the body, is it safe then for humans?
Yeah. There's plenty of amino acids that we don't naturally find in the body, but are in the environment, and there are foods, and they're in nature, and they're all, most of them are benign. Most of them don't cause any problems. And this is one of them. It's L-phenylalanine.
And any reason then that while it's causing that cancer cell to self-destruct, that it could somehow damage healthy cells around it?
Well, that's a concern I certainly have. When I first read the article, my question looking at it is, how are these nanoparticles going to differentiate cancer cells from normal cells? And how are we going to protect normal cells from it? But the researchers apparently are working on that and finding a way that the cancer cells would selectively absorb these nanoparticles.
Were there particular types of cancer cells that it worked, better on than others?
Well, they tried a few different types. They found it worked well on breast cancer and on skin cancer, I think.
And you mentioned that it's testing on mice first. So this is really very interesting. And of course, it could be revolutionary when it comes to treating cancer. Any idea when this might be available to the public, if at all?
No, I think it would be a while before it's available. Most studies begin on mice. And we hear about all these great cancer breakthroughs or heart disease breakthroughs, lots of breakthroughs. And they're usually done on mice first. And very few of them actually pan out. That being said, however, all the ones that have panned out have started in animal studies. And so I always have, when I hear these things, I always have hope. And I always pay close attention to these sort of studies and try to follow them along. Because this is where these things begin that eventually become something that's good and helps us with patients.
So we know that many recurrent cancers become resistant to drugs. I mean, this could be really just fantastic because it doesn't involve any drugs at all.
Right. So what happens now is that a lot of cancers after time become resistant to drugs. A cancer has a very heterogeneous population of cells, and most of them are sensitive to certain drugs, but there's a small population that's not. Eventually, when the ones that are sensitive to the chemotherapy drugs or whatever, when they die off, that small population that's not sensitive begins to grow and grow and grow. And so the chemotherapeutics don't really help anymore. So things like this that are not chemotherapy have the potential to help us with cancers that become resistant to normal chemotherapy by going into the cell and destroying the cell from inside.
Well, let's hope this works. Dr. Scott Ackerman joining us this morning via Zoom. Appreciate your time.
Thank you.